OK，广告之后欢迎回来。那么，观众朋友们，大家好！您现在收看到的是呢正在直播的《早安加拿大》。那么现在呢，大家可以看到我身边来了一位神秘的嘉宾啊。我们先不介绍他是谁。那么今天呢，我们跟大家说一个非常有意思的话题，就是夏天来了呢。在多伦多的周边啊，有很多的这个有意思的一些节日，比如说我们大家都知道，越来越多的这个像音乐节呀，还有这个 Food Festival 啊，食品节啊，都已经慢慢的这个开始在这个 GTA 的周边蔓延开始了。那我们今天呢，就请到了其中一个最大型的，也是一个非常国际化的、非常有意思的一个音乐的一个 event， 也就是一个相当于音乐节的一个活动的负责人，来到我们的节目现场，跟大家聊一聊，他们这一个活动到底有一些怎样的一些特色。Okay, so welcome to our studio today, and could you please briefly introduce about yourself and your role in this event to the audience?
Sure.Good morning. My name is Paolo Becca. I'm managing director and founder of the company musicably.com and also managing director of Make Music Day Markham. Make Music Day Markham is part of global activities related to making music, which is on June 21st, which is summer solstice.
Okay, so 刚刚呢，我们的这个旁边的这位嘉宾啊，已经提到了这个他们的这个音乐节，名字呢就叫做 Make Music Markham。那现在呢，我就要有几个比较有意思的问题要问一下我们旁边的这位嘉宾了。So I have a few questions about you and the Make Music Markham event. So you have mentioned that it is something, it is held in the longest day of the year, right? Celebrating
Yes.
the summer solstice. So why are you choosing? Why are the, this event choosing this day, specific day, and are there any special meaning?Or
well, sure, it's summer solstice, mm-hmm. the longest day of the year mm-hmm. when summer starts, hopefully. Mm-hmm. And the whole event started 36 years ago in France. At the time, mm-hmm. French Minister of Culture, Jacques Lang, decided that this would be a great way how to celebrate some music.So from that time, in 36 years, it grew to more than 120 countries all over the world and 800 cities. And here in Canada, in English-speaking Canada, we are the second city after Edmonton.
What is the, okay, Edmonton.
Yes.
So, 所以呢，我们的爱德蒙顿和我们的 Markham 万景啊，是在英语区的加拿大呢唯一的两个城市，现在举办了这个非常国际化的 Make Music 这样的一个音乐节了。那么接下来呢，我想问一下，在 Markham 有多少年了 ？So how many days, how many years have Make Music been through the?Been through in Markham?
This is our first year,
so
this is our debut,
and
we are hoping to start a tradition which will grow from Markham all over GTA area.
It's great, good luck. So another question will be like, can you give me another, like some example cities about other cities around the world instead of Canada or France that is holding these?
Well, I have to mention France mm-hmm. because Paris almost stops on June 21st. Mm-hmm. They close part of the city. Subway has special schedule and people just go out mm-hmm. and play music.
It's like a national event. Like
it is. It is
Paris,
definitely.
Right?
Similar happens mm-hmm. in Berlin, in Germany, in Brussels, in Johannesburg, in South Africa, in Adelaide, in Australia.And in the United States, this year there will be more than 80 cities participating.
Oh.
And even whole states of Vermont will be participating.
What about Asia? Have you been introduced in Asia?
Yes, last year in China, uh-huh. They had more than 2,000 venues.
Already in China last year?
Yes, with more than 50,000 mm-hmm. participating performers.
Oh, nice. So now I want to talk about the event itself because you know that it's summer coming and there's a lot of like music festival, food festival around in GTA, right? So in terms of content and participants' experience, so can you talk about like what is the difference or what is the major unique theme to distinguish between Make Music Markham and other music festivals?
Sure. Mm-hmm. First thing I would like to emphasize that we like to speak about Make Music Day as a celebration.
Oh.
It's not a traditional music festival mm-hmm. where you have audience on one side and then performers,
yeah.
entertainers on mm-hmm. the other side, and people who are in the audience just passively are waiting someone will entertain them.
Mm-hmm.
This is different because this is for everyone to participate, to make music, to touch instruments. Maybe they were dreaming their whole life to try it. And this is their unique opportunity. In different cities, there are special sessions where people teach how to play ukulele or harmonica. There are free sessions for learning how to play guitar. Everything related
to... And it covers all ages, right?
Absolutely. Yeah. And I want to stress also that this is not for only for professional musicians. This is for amateurs, for music students, and everyone else who
everyone
is willing
who
to try.
Everyone who enjoy or who are interested into music,
absolutely.
Right? So we're mentioning that the event is holding in order for everyone who are interested in music to join. So I would like to ask you some questions about how to become a musician and how to become a performer in this event. So if I think myself are very interested in music and I can play guitar or I think I sing very well, how should I know that am I eligible to become a musician into this event and can I give a show?
Sure, absolutely. The way how Make Music Day works is that we have a special website where performers and venues open to host events are registering. So you as a potential performer, you can go to our website, which is www.makemusicday.org/markham. There you can click on participate and it will bring you to another website where you can register
online
as a performer. There is a couple questions which will ask you what are your requirements. And on the other side, if someone decides to host as a venue one of the events, they do the same. And then our software will match these people. So if someone wants to host solo, only solo performers with only acoustic instruments, they can do that. If someone wants to host, maybe we have whole orchestra open to play, they can do this. They can have DJs, they can have rappers. This is not bringing unknown people on someone's stage, although that stage could be your backyard.
So the website, you just like they will assign the musicians to different venues that can match their requirements, right?
Musician can ask to play on certain venues, and venues can ask to get certain performers.
Nice.
And again, this doesn't need to be music, traditional music venue. We want to bring music out. Hopefully the weather will cooperate. So to play in parks, in your backyard, in front of your store, restaurant, bar,
maybe
on the street.
Maybe outdoor is better than indoor.
Absolutely.
Right?
Outdoor. This is an outdoor event. Just sometimes the weather is unpredictable. So we try to find venues which can also host inside. But ideally, this is happening all outside.
Yeah, that would be very nice. So in this year, what is the deadline to apply?
Well,
to become a venue provider or to become a host or to become a performer?
Well, because we started for the first time, we have postponed the deadline. So the deadline is June 18th. So everyone who is interested to get information, please go to our website. And there, if you decide, you can still register and we will try to find venue for you or try to find performers for the venue.
So talking about the performers, do you have any standards, specific standards, like who can actually perform or who are not eligible to give a performance?
No, everyone who wants to try to make music is eligible. Obviously, some strange types of music which are potentially illegal, definitely not. Otherwise, we don't assess music abilities of everyone or anyone.
So there will be no auditions before the event, and people just can just go to the website to register, to apply, and then they could just play.
And on top of it, we hope that just people who will be walking outside and they will see one of our venues, they will just join maybe 5 minutes, maybe 1 hour, and they will entertain themselves by making music with other musicians.
Yeah. So talking about the venues, we know that there will be different various kind of venues because like there will be public park, there will be like backyards, there will be public other public places, right?
Yes.
So around with the, around different places like within Markham City, or they will not become like
not only Markham City, because there is unfortunately no other municipality organizing this year. So whoever is interested, whether it's in Toronto, Pickering, Ajax, Vaughan, or any other municipality,
so let's say GTA or
something. Absolutely,
okay.
Everyone can register, and we will have an application for smartphones where they can find our city, and on a map, all approved venues and performers will be found. So if someone will try to find it, they can just go there.
So they can just download your app on the smartphone, and then they can. So people who are interested to go to the events that day, they can find on the map that which area are nearest or which area are holding the specific type of music that they are interested to. So they can just go to those specific areas.
Exactly.
Okay, that's very interesting. So I would like to talk about the sponsoring thing, because I know that at the beginning you mentioned that your company has sponsoring these Make Museum events, right? So
yes.
Can you talk about like why are you choosing to sponsor these specific Make Music Markham event, and other than instead of other music events or festivals?
Well, because making music is what our company musicably.com is about. We try to help people find how to make music mindfully. So we try to persuade people that there is not necessary to learn a music instrument for years. There are music instruments which are simple, and everyone can master it in a couple hours. And that is very compatible with what Make Music Day is about. So I've decided that this is perfect to help this idea of bringing music on summer solstice out and help people to find what is it making music themselves.
So just like everybody enjoy the music, and whoever are interested in music can join the event and can give a show freely, right?
Yes,
thank
absolutely.
You so much, fellow. Thank you so much for coming today.
Thank you very
it's
much.
Very happy to talking with you. So, 因为时间的关系呢，我们今天要现在要进一段广告。那么广告之后回来呢，我们还有另一位神秘的嘉宾来到我们的现场做一个采访。那我们会继续我们的采访 ，after 一个广告了。好，广告之后欢迎回来，我们继续我们音乐节的这样的一个话题啊。我们刚刚说了这个 Make Music。Make Music Markham 这个活动，对吧？那我们刚刚也说到了，就是嘉宾也提到了，它和别的音乐节啊完全不一样，因为呢，它是一个今年第一次在Markham 在我们这个万锦市举行，而且呢，它是一个完全的大型的国际化的 free 的一个可以让任何的喜欢音乐的朋友，不管是任何的形式来到我们的音乐节去参与、去表演，或者是提供场地等等都可以，对吗？
对。
那我们现在呢，很高兴请来了另外一位女士，美丽的 Mary 嘉宾来到我们的现场。那么 Mary 听说也是我们这一次的一个相当于是一个义工这样的一个情况，是吗？
对对对。
那你可以给大家简单的介绍一下你的一个负责的工作和你的职位吗？
好的，大家好啊，我呢叫 Mary。我在这个项目中呢是完全的是一个义工。我认识啊 Pavel 就刚才的那个项目主任呢很久了，那 Pavel 呢也来找我说，特别是在万锦，在加拿大，在特别是万锦，我们有很大的华人社区，华人社区也非常在音乐方面也非常积极，我们很多小朋友都会在学乐器，爸爸妈妈在很小就让他们学乐器，那音乐在我们的生活中呢也起了很大作用。所以 Pavel 呢来说好不好，我也在华人社区来宣传，那我知道我们华人社区我们说中文有一些些不同的地方，所以呢我很愿意来帮助，所以我现在呢是 volunteer， 我也是项目助理，有一些需要 管理啊事情，还有网站上的事情，我会帮忙来做。
那为什么当初想要答应 Paolo？ 就是除了这个你们是朋友之外，那么这个音乐节本身有什么样的一些特点，它是吸引你，然后你觉得是非常有意义的，然后想要去在华人社区或者在整个万锦市或者是多伦多地区去推广这样的一个国际化的活动？
啊，是的，一个呢是这个活动非常大，非常有意义。我觉得它特别不同的呢，它提供的是一个体验。是每个人出来，我们都很多孩子都学了音乐，我们也让孩子学音乐，但是是为什么呢？我们没有这么多音乐家来独奏，而音乐应该在生活中，起很大的作用。那么这个项目提供的是一个大家来用音乐来庆祝我们的生活，
没错，
大家来做，这是完全 free 的，我们有很好的。赞助商提供场地然后也大家可以到
还有一些
室外对室外去，就是享受就是 enjoy 这个 music， 就是要去享受，就像生活一样在巴黎也许欧洲有更强的一些音乐传统我们中国比较内敛经常坐在那里，
但其实这个
欣赏，但我们不去
做。
对，我们现在鼓励的是大家来做，请我们的小朋友出来，也请爸爸妈妈过来体验。你要是不喜欢 music， 你为什么要让你的孩子去学呢？
没错，
你要去体验，所以呢，我觉得是非常有意义，
就是给了一个很好的一个舞台，一个平台，
对的，
让全民，不管是孩子还是家长还是老年人，各个年龄段各种身份的人，
对，
都可以去更加的去了解去体验这样的一个音乐，因为在别的一些音乐节你可能没有这么好的一个平台，
对的，
去自己也去尝试，对不对？
对的，
去学习，或者说我有我觉得我有才华，我也可以去展示，对不对？
对，音乐事实上是艺术是表现的一种语言，所以去体验是非常好。在中国我也是刚刚知道说在中国去年就开始是中国乐器协会在组织这个样的一个活动，那么就很简单，就是说你也许有一个人在一生中想学但是没有机会，这是非常好的机会去体验，去看，去交流，也许唱一首歌也很好。
没错，我觉得这样一个平台，这样的理念和我们加拿大国家电视台非常像，怪不得我发现我们加拿大国家电视台也是今年我们 Make Music Markham 的媒体赞助了。那为什么会这么像呢？就是因为我们都有一个想法说要给大家，给小朋友，给所有的这个喜欢艺术或者喜欢音乐的朋友一个平台，一个舞台去体验或者去展示我们的才华，因为我们一直以来也是做的一个这样的一个活动，这样的一个理念了，非常的棒。我觉得那刚刚您说到您是 volunteer 是志愿者对吗？
对。
那我想再帮很多的喜欢这个有兴趣做 volunteer 的年轻的朋友问一下问题了，因为我们都知道每当有这个像音乐节啊或者大型的一些 event 的时候啊，都要招募很多的志愿者，
对，
对不对？
对。
然后呢很多的这个年轻朋友啊读高中的读大学的他们就想多去参与这样的一些活动，
对，
然后就会很有兴趣。那我想知道我们这个活动有在招志愿者吗？
有的。
应该怎样去参与呢？
有的，就像 Paul 刚才说的我们那个网站上你可以参与，是你可以参与作为表演的，或者说你是我愿意提供场地，还有一个件就是我愿意参与作为义工。我们当然很需要义工，因为各个场地有的时候需要放一些椅子需要去安排一些活动这个是我们会非常非常欢迎我们的义工，
每一个 venue 都会有义工去 follow 这一个活动，然后去保证这个活动在很开心的举行，对不对？
对，其实从某种意义上每一个参与的人就是义工，因为这是没有钱的，这是完全一个免费的
一个公益，
这个是完全的一个公益，把你自己投入进来，用音乐来表达你自己，然后我们在一起在这个一个特定的日子里，每年都是在这个特定的日子里
去举行，
去举行，去宣传 music， 宣传表达你自己，用音乐来表达，这是一个非常好的活动。
是，而且我觉得把这个日子定在这个一年中最长的一天非常的好，
对的，
因为白天长呢，我们的活动就会更长，对不对？
对的，
大家就可以有更多的时间去 celebrate， 去 enjoy 我们的音乐。那刚刚大家也看到这个 Mary 女士一提到这个活动，眉飞色舞，非常的激动，非常的热情。那我相信您肯定本人也是非常的期待这一次的一个活动了。那我最后想问一下您，就是这个活动现在有没有什么特别推荐的一些地点啊，或者是一些已经报名的一些 performers 啊，一些表演的一些团队啊，那么现在他们已经报名了，你有没有什么特别推荐大家可以当天不妨去这些地方看一下这样的一些演出呢？
对 大家都知道，一到了夏天啊，加拿大各地都有各种各样的活动。那么那天呢，正好其实呢也是各个音乐节举行的时候，这一段时间里，我们有几个非常好的赞助商，然后我们有一非常好的音乐家在演出，大家可以去看的。一个是 Stanley Piano Gallery。就是在这边附近啊，然后他们把他们非常完美的音乐厅，然后很好的钢琴请大家来玩，然后呢我们已经有一些非常好的年轻人在那里要在那里表演也在他们自己也是玩音乐，其实不仅仅是表演，最主要的这个节目大家可以来。我们在 Markham Village 的图书馆之前也有一个音乐小组在那里我们在 Unionville， 那 Unionville 当天7:30以后会有节目，我们在 Unionville 那条街上也有一些演出是这样。然后我们还有一些像 Infinity Music Hall， 我们也正在去联系。然后非常感谢加拿大电视台也是给我们这样的一个机会来讨论。
我们加拿大国家电视台也是非常的荣幸能够一起参与这样的一个这么有意义的这样的一个活动了。那最后想问一下您，就是不好意思，就想说一下那一天的话，是不是如果我是一个家长，然后我的孩子比如说非常喜欢吉他或者是钢琴，或者是他这个唱歌非常厉害，我也可以去到现场看一下有没有机会我也让他上去这个表演一首啊？
对
呀，
可以啊，
或者是认识更多的厉害的老师啊前辈 啊都可以在这个音乐节当中去有一个很好的交流，对吗？
对对对，有兴趣的不管是家长还是孩子还是年轻人其实最好的办法就是去在网站上注册登记然后找到你喜欢的地方，甚至于就在你的家门口家后院，如果你能聚集你们的同学在一起表演真的就是很好。我女儿现在就是在做这桩事情，因为她也玩乐器，所以她有一个小组，他们一个小组就会在室外就会有一些表演。然后
对啊，
对
啊，感觉这样的一个活动非常的难得。那么今天讲了以后，我自己也是非常的期待，回去我要赶紧推荐我的一些朋友啊，赶紧去注册当这个volunteer， 对不对？而且呢就喜欢音乐的朋友啊也可以多多去参与了。那么电视机前的你呢，如果你觉得你也有很有才华或者是很感兴趣的话呢，不要忘了赶紧去我们 Music Markham 的网站去了解一下，去注册了。
对，
今天也是非常的开心能够请到 Mary 女士到现场跟我们聊天，刚刚真的非常的开心看到您聊的这么的激动然后非常的热情也相信您也是投入了非常多的这样的一个热情和心血到这个活动当中，也非常祝愿和期待我们这个 May Music Markham 当天能够顺利成功的举行了。
谢谢。
那么今天时间有限，我们现在先进一段广告，接下来呢我们有财经消息。